Hi, welcome or welcome back to the War and Peace Book Club. This is the books 13 through 15 discussion video. If you are new here, hello, my name is Kelsey. I read today. This is a part of a video series I co-host with my friend Gabriel, where we've been reading War and Peace and putting out little discussion videos of our thoughts of each little chapter. So like I said, we're talking about books 13 through 15. You can go back and re-watch some of the old videos, or you can watch this one. Either way, we're about to start talking about the chapters. So book 13, I took little to no notes on this chapter, and to be fair, it was a relatively short chapter compared to every other part of War and Peace. Part 13 was incredibly underwhelming for me, only because books 11 and 12 were just phenomenal. So much happened in it, and I was flipping pages aggressively. Because in parts 11 and 12, we had all the drama surrounding Andre and then his death, and then we had Pierre on a manhunt for Napoleon and then getting captured. We had the love triangle between Nikolai, Sonia, and Mary. It was just so much going on, and I was just so engrossed. I don't remember the texts I sent Gabriel during this part, but I was going through it. So like, I'll flash those on the screen maybe, I don't know.
Gabriel, I'm going through it, man.
From what I remember, I don't have much to say about book 13 because, again, it was a lot of the historical aspects of the book, and if you know me, you know I'm very bad at just reading. Maybe it's just my lack of reading comprehension, but I remember jumping from, like, how did we go from this to, like, a Napoleon biopic? Like, this was Napoleon's moment to shine, and I was like, you can't just leave off on that cliffhanger. Other than the Napoleon stuff in chapter 13, Pierre got captured, and we kind of see him just go through his development. I really liked Pierre in this chapter. I feel like Pierre as a character has just gone through so much and a lot of like self-change that I feel like this was just a really solidifying moment in his like final emergence or like final character arc. I did not take many notes on this part, so that's all I have to say about book 13. If you have something, please, please drop it in the comments. Okay. Part 14 time. This is where I had all my fun. Although I don't know if I can describe it as fun because I would get really excited about things and then they would get crushed like a page later. So we get the return of one of my favorite characters, Dolokhov. That had me hyped. So Dolokhov is sent on like a spy mission with Natasha's younger brother Petya, and he basically has to disguise himself as a French soldier to find out information on the Russian prisoners. So we got a few cute moments with Dolokhov and Petya, and I said this over the Discord. I was like, OMG, Dolokhov is so good with kids, I'm simping. And then like a page later, Petya dies, and I was like, oh, well, he's not that good with kids. Petya's death was sad for me, but like the second he enlisted in the army, I knew it was gonna happen. I was like, oh, Tolstoy's gonna kill this kid off, okay. War and Peace has been dealing with the tragedies of war, but having the death of Petya and Andre back to back just really ties in the war to our central characters. This is when we see it make a direct impact. That, along with the burning of Moscow, we see come to a head and just have our characters clash with the war and really just how it affects the aristocratic societies. And that's a really cool thing to watch unfold. Don't know if cool is the right word. So okay, picture this. I'm recovering from these deaths. I'm upset. I finally find solace in Pierre cuddling a cute gray dog, and I am very adamant about this dog being my new favorite character because he's the only pure thing we've seen so far. Because at this moment, I believe there is no more good in the world, and the only good can be found in that little dog Pierre is holding. You wanna know what happens next? They shoot the dog! They shoot the dog! I know Tolstoy's going for the casualties of war and how that affects the lives, but come on, you know you don't go for the dog. I just can't have anything nice. But Dolokhov and Denisov are able to free Pierre, and Pierre has to rejoin society after all this time away. And that's the last we see of Dolokhov. I've finished the book. We don't get any more of him, and it makes me sad. I just can't have anything nice. Now, time for part 15. I loved part 15. It is the last part of War and Peace before the two epilogues. One of my favorite aspects of this chapter is how close Natasha and Princess Mary get after the death of Prince Andre. They find solace and comfort in each other, and I really loved their relationship. Because at the beginning, you had these two women who didn't like each other, they didn't really understand each other, and then this tragic event just brings them together and they become close friends, almost like sisters, and I love that. One of the tragically funny, Natasha just has the worst timing, and I just find it so funny. One of the tragic things, Natasha is upset, she's been grieving, and she sees her family like distraught, and she's like, what do they know of sadness? And 2 seconds later, she finds out her younger brother died, and she was like, oh. I loved how Natasha, like, she's like, I have to pull out of this so I can help my family, because Natasha is so loving and she just strives in helping others, and I love that about her. And I loved watching Natasha take care of her mother, especially since throughout the book we've only seen her mother taking care of her. The whole book we've just seen Countess Rostov take care of her kids, and as a reader we know that her family is the only thing that matters to her, and having it fall apart and then having Natasha try and help fix it was just really great, and you can see the similarities in their characters, and I love that. Pierre has lost some money after the burning of Moscow, but he feels richer in heart. But of course he's also lost his wife and his best friend, so he has to pay Princess Mary a visit, because we need to check in on each other. And he visits her and he doesn't recognize Natasha. Like, she is completely changed from the past events, and the fact that he didn't recognize her was just so funny to me. He had to like keep doing double takes. He's like, oh. And once he realizes it's Natasha, he understands that he loves Natasha with all his heart. And Pierre and Natasha hit it off really hard, and it's angsty, and I love, one of my favorite tropes is mutual pining after each other, and I love it. Both Pierre and Natasha have this emotional openness to the world, and I've said this a bunch, but they just even each other out really well, and they just understand each other in a way that no one else can. Both of them have lost and loved so much, and they just keep finding their way back to each other, and that's just another one of my favorite tropes. This whole chapter was just everything I love. And part 15 ends with Princess Mary watching them and being like, oh, this needs to happen. Because we love Princess Mary in this house, and she loves a good pairing when she sees it. I finished my notes! I have nothing else to save. All of these chapters this time were relatively short and kind of stuck to one story, so I didn't have much to go over. These were my like big thoughts and big notes. I just love War and Peace so much, and the next video is gonna be the epilogues, and it's so sad that this is coming to an end, because I love talking about this book and you guys are the only ones who understand what I'm talking about. Thank you for following us on this journey. Feel free to talk to me about WAP anytime. I love it. I don't know how to end this video, so here's a funny tweet that Katie tweeted at me and Gabriel.
How'd you get this photo of us?